wake up. We need a wake-up call. And in 1986, I got the call. I was in a triathlon in Palm Springs, California, and I was in the biking portion of the race. And I was coming up to this intersection. So as I made the turn, a four-wheel drive Bronco going about 55 miles an hour hit me from behind and catapulted me out of my bicycle. The compressive force compressed 6 vertebrae in my spine. The prognosis was I'd probably never walk again, and that I needed a radical surgery called the Harrington Rod surgery. If this had been anybody else, I probably would have recommended that they have surgery, but this was me. I decided to check out of the hospital, and I just had this one thought, and the thought was the power that made the body heals the body. And I couldn't stop thinking about that because I knew that there's an intelligence that's giving us life that keeps our heart beating and digesting our food. So I decided that I was going to make contact with this intelligence, and I was going to give it a plan, a template, a design. And when I was happy with my creation, I was going to surrender this creation to a greater mind because it knows how to heal way better than I do. And the second thing I said was, I'm not going to let any thought slip by my awareness that I don't want to experience. So I would start off in my mind reconstructing my spine vertebrae per vertebrae. And then I'd start thinking about living in a wheelchair. So for 6 weeks, I went through this incredible dark night of the soul because I couldn't really get my mind to do what I wanted it to do. And it would take me about 3 hours closing my eyes and reconstructing every single vertebrae. I'm starting over again every time I lost my attention. At the end of 6 weeks, I went through the whole entire process without losing my attention. And it was like I hit a tennis ball in the sweet spot. Something clicked in that moment. I clicked. I started noticing significant changes in my body. My motor functions started coming back, and my body began to change dramatically. And I was back on my feet in 10 weeks, and back training again in 12 weeks. And I just made a deal with myself. And the deal was that if I was ever able to walk again, I'd spend the rest of my life studying the mind-body connection and mind over matter. And pretty much that's what I've been doing since 1986.